Melissa, and I'm curious, what do you know about stem cells?
Well, unfortunately, I really don't know that much about stem cells. The first thing that comes to mind is abortion, which I'm not for abortion. But as far as stem cells itself, I really don't have that much information about that.
I don't know that much about stem cells. I've heard they can come from a couple of different places, but I heard that some about has to do with abortion and getting the stem cells from the fetus. So I really can't answer your questions. I don't know that much about it.
I think that stem cell research is a great breakthrough in science, regardless of where it comes from, because it's for the greater good of humanity.
As far as brainstem cell research goes, I'm all for it, although I have to say I'm slightly uncomfortable with some of the techniques used to acquire them.
Stem cells we know nothing about. There's a lot they can do with stem cells besides throwing them away. Because like today, you know, it's a waste just to get rid of something because somebody says it's aborting stuff and that, they don't know what they're talking about.
I think that stem cell research should be a wonderful thing no matter where the stem cells come from.
Stem cell research, it's a means to the end. It's inevitable.
What if a miracle cure or treatment could be derived to address previously untreatable afflictions like stroke, traumatic brain injury, multiple sclerosis, or muscular dystrophy by naturally occurring stem cells taken from your own body?
Well, I think with hearing all that information on adult stem cells, I think it's a wonderful thing. And if they could be used to help somebody, I think it's a great thing.
I didn't know you could get stem cells from your own body. That really makes a lot more sense now for them to really be doing heavy research in that area. They don't have to get them from a fetus of a baby or something like that.
If what you're saying is true, it sounds like a remarkable breakthrough in modern science.
As far as getting stem cells from an adult, I see absolutely nothing that I could possibly be against anyways. I would be all for it.
Stem cells is the greatest thing going if you don't hurt anybody using it. Well, I'm 100% for stem cell usage in that.
I'm all for stem cell research. And especially if they could come from me. Wow, that would just be great.
I've driven a car for over 30-something years. I've carried a spare tire with me. And now you're telling me I got a spare tire in me? Take care of myself? Of course I'm going to use it.
How, do you ask? Well, I am not even going to try and explain and quite possibly bore you with the technical jargon. So I'm going to need a little help on this one.
Well, please step aside, Melissa, and I, Patrick Apollonia, will be more than happy to take on that assignment. Let me ask you a question. How do you think a broken bone mends or wound heals? Magic? 20 Hail Marys? No. The body continually produces stem cells from conception until death and utilizes them to handle all of the body's needs. It'd be my pleasure to tell you how and walk you through the adult stem cell acquisition and subsequent treatment processes currently being used all over the world to do remarkable things. Everywhere in the world other than the United States, that is.
Really? Why is this revolutionary new technique being used everywhere but the United States?
Well, there are a few parties to blame here. First, we have an overzealous church who's afraid to anger God by killing babies. Secondly, we have the greedy pharmaceutical companies, who are afraid to diminish their already ridiculous profits by introducing something they can treat and possibly cure what their drugs are used for. Disregarding the uncanny potential currently lying dormant in this untouched new science, these unsavory entities wish for you to remain sick and ignorant, so they can continue to squander your cash for their own selfish needs. Finally, the fact that all the mass media seems to talk about are stem cells of the embryonic kind, thusly leaving adult stem cells out of the public eye.
Removing the Ocular Wool is a documentary designed to help bring to light the potential of and to clear up the cloud of negativity currently surrounding stem cell therapy's consideration as a viable treatment in the U.S. by explaining the entire process. We will further substantiate our claims by showcasing effective treatment on Mr. Daniel Diaz, who will undergo stem cell therapy to combat his ailment of multiple sclerosis, a previously untreatable and extremely disabling disease, thus proving stem cell therapy is worth consideration. Removing the ocular wool will do away with the cloud of misinformation currently causing adverse reactions and severe opposition to the entire stem cell therapy idea. Preventing it from infiltrating the United States is a viable process, thus holding America back from retaking its place as the leader in new and innovative technology the world over. Thank you.